this equation, I'm provided with an equation, and I'm told the values that are inputted in for x have to be greater than 1. And I want to know a possible output value for y. So let's start with the next integer that's greater than 1. When I substitute in 2, I end up with an output of 2 over 2 minus 1 is 1, and I know that's equivalent to 2.0. And I'm just going to do a few more of these. So I input in 3, 3 minus 1 is 2, and that's equivalent to 1.5. Let's go to 4, input in 4, 4 minus 1 is 3, that's 1.3 repeating. Let's do one more. I should have put x here, sorry. The input is 5, and the output is 5, 5 minus 1 is 4, that's equivalent to 1.25. So in each situation, using this equation, I can see when I input values for x that are greater than 1, I get an output in every case that has the numerator being 1 greater than the denominator. Also, because x's are greater than 1, I get answers that are always positive. I eliminate any choice that does not provide me with a positive output. When the number on top, the numerator, is greater than the denominator, as I have, I will get an answer that is always greater than 1. I could even choose to not stop at 5 and go like all the way to maybe an input value of, let's say, 20. If I input 20, based on the pattern, if my input is 20, the numerator would be 20 and the denominator would be 19. And we can see that 20 divided by 19 is still a value that is greater than 1. So this would be a possible choice. Again, when the numerator is greater than the denominator, your value will always be greater than 1. Final answer is E.